I'm Dr. Akkerman. Let's talk about the history of rock and roll. Let's get some common terminology going first so that we can have some language that we can use throughout these lectures. So what is rock and roll or rock music to you? What do you think about? If somebody were to say to you, I love rock music, what does that make you think of? What kinds of styles of music? What groups? What artists? Is it loud and powerful? Is it kind of soft and pretty? Can it be a little bit of both? Rock music can mean a lot of things to a lot of people. It's not always the same thing, right? So for our purposes, we're going to think of rock music as being an overall umbrella term, a genre, but with lots of subgenres within it. And that's the beauty of rock music as we talk about it from a point of view of history, is understanding all of those subgenres and how they add to the overall genre that we just call rock music. So keep in mind that rock music might mean something kind of specific to you, but there's more to it, and that every other person might have a slightly different take on it. So that's the goal of these lectures, is to impress upon you the bigger picture and maybe get a wider appreciation for what rock music can mean to lots of other people. A commonality across all these different subgenres that rock music can have is called form. Okay, very simply, what's form in music? It's the order that stuff happens. So even though you might have country rock, blues rock, polka rock, whatever, the order that things happen, there is some commonality between all these different genres. So that we can break the different sections of songs down and give these different sections a label. And one of the main things that most rock music has in common is a verse and a chorus. Those are the two main sections of most songs. I'm just going to use a classic kind of sing-along tune that you might recognize. Here's the verse. Nibbling on sponge cake, watching the sun bake. All those tourists covered in gold, strumming my six string. And then another verse would happen, right? So a verse and a chorus. So the function of the verse is to offer the storyline. It presents the characters to you, whatever information you need to somehow develop an interest in the song. And you also get to hear the main melody of the tune. The chorus is a summation of whatever information is given to you in the verse. And it will be usually repetitive. It'll show up two or three times in the song, maybe more. And it'll often have a vocal hook that is often the name of the song. In this case, you know, Margaritaville is the name of this tune. The word Margaritaville is in the chorus, and it has that big hook at the end of it. Some people claim there's a woman to blame. And then the verse will come in again, a second verse. And verses usually have new information each time they occur, while the chorus typically has almost the identical lyrical information each time we hear it. And then sometimes within songs there'll be an interlude, a musical solo portion, or perhaps what we call a bridge, which is a new section for the vocals, a little deviation. And that usually comes in after the second chorus. A real popular form for a lot of rock songs would be a verse and a chorus, and then a second verse and a repeat of the chorus, and then the deviation of some sort, a little musical section or a vocal bridge. And then, depending on the song, maybe a return to the last chorus, or maybe a third verse that can happen occasionally. That's a pretty typical format for a tune. So even though we can have so many different styles of rock music, the idea of structure is a commonality between all of them. The next time you're listening to any of the music you enjoy, take a listen to it as far as structure goes. Can you name the form of that song? If there's a little introduction, and then is there a verse and a chorus? And then if after that, what happens? Second verse, second chorus. Is the second chorus identical to the first one, or are there any changes to it? Is there a bridge? Is there a solo? Depending on the style of music you like to listen to, there may be more solos than other. Country music has some guitar solos or fiddle solos. Heavy metal has a lot of guitar solos. More dance-oriented pop music, not too many solos, but they'll definitely have a vocal bridge on a regular basis. So as you're listening to the music you enjoy, take a listen now with that new sort of appreciation of form, and you will find throughout all the songs you're listening to, they all have a very clear form that you could sit down and label. Listen for them. Verse, chorus, and maybe a bridge. Have fun.